students. Today also we'll continue with exercise 10.8, R.S. Agarwal book, chapter 10, Profit and Loss. So today I will explain two questions, question number 10 and question number 11. These are very, very important sum. So what we have in question number 10 is a jeweler allows a discount of 16%. So first of all, you always have to see that what are the datas given in the question and what you have to find out. This is what is the first thing that you should do when you read the question. So a jeweler allows a discount of 16%. So what is given? Discount percent is given. That is 16% discount the jeweler is giving on an item. So to his customer and still gains 20%. And still he is gaining 20% students. After allowing a discount of 16%, still the jeweler is gaining 20%. Now what we have to find out? Find the mark price of a ring. So we are talking about the item is what? Ring. Okay? Item is ring. So what is the mark price of the ring which cost the jeweler 1190? That is the cost price of the jeweler is 1190. Okay, so that means at what price jeweler has bought this ring is 1190. Fine. So what we have to find out? Mark price. So these are the complete data which are given in the question. Now, discount percent is given, gain percent is given, cost price is given, and you have to find the mark price. For this, whenever you have to find out mark price wise, you always have to use this formula, that is SP equals to MP minus discount. Okay, so once you have written this formula, now you have to see that which are the things are given and which you have to find out. Now see, mark price you have to find out. So to find out this mark price, you have to know SP and discount, isn't it? Here discount percent is given, not in the rupee form. Discount, you have to find discount, that is should be in the rupee form, that is a value. And SP you have to know. Now how to get this SP? We'll target this first, because we have to know this two data first, then only we can find out NP. Now if I have to find out SP, we have to see that what are the data is given in the question. So to find out SP, these two data can help me out. That is gain and CP, isn't it? So what is the formula of SP when CP and gain percent is given? So we have to know this. I hope we have studied this in the previous exercise. So when SP, when CP and gain percent, when CP and gain percent is given, okay, when CP and gain percent is given, SP would be equals to CP into 100 plus profit percent by 100. So this is the formula that we have to work out. So now what is the value of CP? CP is 1190. So 1190 into 100 plus what is given? 20 by 100. Okay, so that would be 1190 into 120 by 100. Now let's reduce the zeros, students. Now this zero and this zero. So finally it will look like 119 into 12. So your required answer would be 1428. If you multiply 119 into 12, you will get this answer. Now you see, he bought the ring at rupees 1190 and he's selling the ring at rupees 1428. So definitely he's gaining. So it is quite clear that we are right with the value because he's gaining. Okay. Now what we have to find out? Mark price. So we are aware of SP value now. The SP is what? 1428. So this part is done. Now we are not aware of MP and discount. So until and unless we do not know MP, we won't be able to know what is a discount. Because always remember that discount is always given on the mark price. Okay, whatever the price is written on the article boys. Okay, whatever the price is written on the article, on this price only the discount will be given. That is on mark price. So to get the value of discount, we have to let the value of MP. Okay, so let the MP be X. Now as we have assumed MP as X, now we can find out the value of discount. As discount percent is given what? 16%. So on the mark price, if this mark price is X, okay, now we can give the discount percent on this MP, isn't it? So So the discount would be what? 16% of NP. NP is what? X. So 16% of X means 16 by 100 into X. That would be 16X by 100. Now, again we'll see this formula. We are aware of SP value, that is 148. MP we have assumed as what? X. And after we have assumed MP as X, what is the discount we got? That is 16X by 100. Now we can use all those formulas. That is this one. Okay, this one. And this one. These are the three values that we have to use in this formula. And then, after that, we can get the value of X. Because our main objective is to get the value of X. Okay. So now we'll use this formula. SP is equals to MP minus discount. Now, in place of SP, we'll write 1428. This is SP value. What is MP? We have assumed MP as X. And what is discount given? 16X by 100. Now, let's solve this part. So, 1428. So, you will give the implied sign here. So, 100. 100X minus 16X. 100X minus 16X, you will get this as 84X by 100. Okay? Now, I'm going to rub this part, that is the top part. Okay, so the rest of the solution I will do it here. Okay, so now to get the value of X, what we have to do, we have to transpose this 184 towards left hand side. So it will look like 1428 into 100 by 84, that will give you the value of X. Okay, once you will reduce this, students, your required answer would be, just a minute, I need to solve this. Okay, so your answer would be, so if you reduce this with 2, suppose, so 2 sevens are 20, 2 sevens are 14, 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8, 2 fours are 2, 42, again it can be reduced by 2, so 2 threes are 6, 2 fives are 10, 2 sevens are 14, 21s are. Okay, now this can be reduced by 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 nines are 27, 3 sevens are. And if I have to reduce this 119 with 7, then the required answer is 17. Okay, so now the value of X would be equals to 17 into 100, that is rupees 17. So this is our mark price. So mark price is what? Rupees 1700. Now just see that on the box it was written 1700 rupees. So on the box it was written 1700. But what the jeweler said to the customer, if it is written 1700, sir, do not worry. I will give you a discount of 16% on it. So after allowing a discount of 16% on this price, he is selling the article at rupees 1428. See, this is how the shopkeeper makes a profit, and this is how they attract the customer towards themselves. Okay, so this is the whole funda of question number 10. Now let's move on to question number 11. In question number 11, see what the data is given. After allowing a discount of 10%, see, it will sound little bit very similar to question number 10, but it is not same. Okay, so after allowing a discount of 10%, so 10% discount percent is given. Fine. On the mark price, a trader still makes a gain of 70%. So there is one trader is there who is selling something. So after allowing a discount of 10% to an article, he still is gaining. That is how much gain? 17%. He's still having a profit of 17%. Now they are saying, what percent, by how much percent MP is greater than CP? This is what you have to find. That is in a percent form. Okay, in a percent form you have to find out. Now it is quite clear that whatever would be the cost price, that is definitely not the mark price. Fine. So that definitely the price at which the trader is buying an article, that would be a cost price. Okay, after buying, what is the price that he is putting on that article? Okay, that is what is the price that he is marking on the article, that is the mark price that we have to write. Fine. So what will be the difference between at what price he has bought and what price he has listed here? So this is what the difference we have to find out first. Now the question is how? Now you see, again we have to find out MP. So I've already said that if you have to find out MP, what you have to go for? SP is equals to MP minus discount. This is a formula that you have to use, isn't it? This is the formula that you have to use. Now, to get the value of SP, you have to know two data, that is CP, gain, or gain percent. Okay, that is CP and gain. So CP, we are not known. We are not aware of CP. But here the profit percent is given 17%. So if I could assume the CP as anything, any value, so we can easily find out SP by using the formula. So this is what exactly we'll do. So what is, let, first of all, we'll target this SP. So to get the value of SP, we have to assume the value of CP. So let the CP be rupees 100. Okay, let it be 100. Okay, now if the CP is 100 and if the trader is making a profit of 17%, so the formula of SP would be CP into 100 plus profit percent by 100. Now just put the values of CP. What is CP we have assumed as? It is 100. 100 plus profit percent is 17 by 100, isn't it? Now just reduce this to 100. So SP is equals to what? Rupees 170. Now suppose a trader has bought the article at rupees 100, and if he is making a profit of 70%, then he will sell the article at rupees 170. Now you see, in this particular formula, we are aware of the value of SP. That is, SP is what? 170. Now, we have to go for MP. As we have already discussed, that until and unless we are not aware of MP, we won't be able to know what is discount. Because discount is always given on MP. That is on market price. So, your next part is, you have to let the MP as X. So, let the MP be X. So if MP is X, the discount given is what? 10%. So discount would be 10% of X. So that is 10 by 100 into X. So that would be what? 10X by 100. I'm not going to reduce this. I will keep it just the way it is. Okay. So now on MPX, discount is given 10X by 100. So in this formula, we are aware of SP value. We know MP also now, and we know discount also. Now use all these values in this formula. So SP is equals to MP minus discount. So SP is 117, MP we have assumed as X, and discount on MP is given 10X by 100. Okay. Now 117, we will go for the LCM, that is 100. 100X minus 10X. So it will be 117 equals to 90X by 100. Okay, now again we'll use this upper portion for the final solution. So I'm going to rub this. So we'll write this as 117 equals to 90x by 100. Okay, now we have to transpose this 90 and 100 towards left hand side to get the value of X. So 100 will be multiplied with 117. And 90 will come down. It will look like this. Now you can reduce the two zeros. So if you have to divide 117 by 9, definitely it is divisible, and the answer would be 13. So the value of X is what? Value of X is 130. So MP is rupees 130. So if I ask you that, what is the price? What is the amount that MP is more than CP? So CP is 100 and MP, what was written on that article? 130. So how much more? So MP is 30 rupees. 30 rupees more than CP. So if MP is 30 rupees more than MP, so what percent? So what we have to decide is, now we have to go for percentage, isn't it? So hence the mark price, so finally we'll write it down. Hence, the mark price is 30% above the cost price. And how 30%? Because out of 100, it is 30. That is, what is the price value? That is, what is the profit making? We have learned about the profit percentage, isn't it? Profit by CP into 100. So profit is what? 30. Cost price is 100 into 100. If you cancel all these things, then you will come up with 30% MP. So hence the mark price is 30% above the cost price. This is the final conclusion that we have to make. Okay, so that's it for today's session, students. I hope you have understood the two questions which I have explained today. So take care, all of you. God bless you and stay blessed.